Hello everyone. So here we are to continue our 3D Dreamcatcher. And I will just continue to do the same as yesterday. Right here, I will definitely need the first round reduction that you will so soon see. So you're watching a new project of mine. A new experiment in which every day I post a new video working on one of my creations, new creations, and these will be 20 minute videos of anything I have in mind to make. It could be dream catchers, it could be mandalas, it could be anything. It also could be some painting, it could be some crystal jewelry, or also pine needle baskets, or also dream catchers made out of pine needles. I don't know what else, but anyway, whatever I will create, I will show you how I make it so that you can learn how to create it, you can see my tricks, or you could just watch these videos and be in good company, and we will see. Maybe in the future I will create also videos for Patreon. Let me know if you think that is a good idea. Patreon is a website where you can support your creator, your online creator, like a YouTuber. So we will see if that is a new possibility for me and for you to be in contact with me and to support me. Otherwise, you can support me buying some of my creations on Etsy. You can find us on Etsy as Crystal Mandala Online. I will put the link in the description and also in the comments. So in Italy, shipping is free. Outside of Italy, it isn't free. Anyways, in case you are from Italy and near to Bergamo, we could see each other to give you what you choose, so that you don't have to, so that I don't have to pay shipping, and so the price could be even less. And also this creation will be on Etsy as soon as I will finish it, so that somebody could purchase it. Otherwise, if you feel like it, just write me in the comments how are you and where are you from, and if you are, what you are working on, what project, what creative project, or your passions in life, your hobbies. And also, please let me know how you found our channel. Also, you can find us and find me on Facebook. Our page is Crystal Mandala, the same. And there is also an online community, Crystal Mandala community, where you could post your pictures, for example, with your creations. For example, if you are following this tutorial, these videos, and you are also creating a 3D dreamcatcher in the meanwhile, you could post some pictures there with your progress. I am not on Facebook every day, but soon I will for sure see your post and your pictures, and I will be really happy to see them, because that means that I am not spending all this time in vain to film my progress, that maybe I'm helping somebody, showing the creative process that I am in right now. I don't know if you can see it, but we are making some progress. As I can see that the net is filling up more and more space in the dreamcatcher. Okay, I finished the string, so this one. You can also order from me personalized special items, special creations. I don't know if you need some special colored mandala or dreamcatcher or anything else. You can just write to me on Facebook, on Messenger, or by email to crystalmandala@hotmail.com, and we will talk a little bit about it, and I will tell you my prices, and I can make you something personalized. So right now I wanted to tell you my doubts about this dreamcatcher, which is really nice, but as you can see right here, these strings are not enough tight. So here it is perfect, like in other spaces. Here there is some imperfection, but still okay. And what else here? Just a second. No, that was... I have already shown you that one. So I can see some spaces, like one or two species of this dream catcher where strings are getting loose. That's the word, getting loose. So I think that this particular technique is not so good for 3D dream catchers. But of course, I will go ahead and continue this experiment and we will see what will happen. I am just trying not to pull so much on the string between between the knots, because that would cause more loosening. So these strings are loosening up a little bit. And if that wasn't the case, I would have made already some reductions. So I would have skipped some of these smaller pieces. So that way, this half circle, let's say, would have closed up a little bit, like on each side and section. And that way, everything would get nearer and nearer to the center of this sphere. If you imagine all this as a sphere. But right now I can't do that because I don't want to get more loosening. Like you can see, if I do like this, as if this were a big reduction, you will see how this area will loosen up. Can you see this? So I can't make reductions, or not too much. So I will go around and around like this. I also cannot change technique because I had a thought that I would return to do this technique, this net. But as I pull on some of these strings like this, can you see that all these strings get loosened up? I think the reason why this is happening, it's really because it's a 3D dream catcher. Because when I do the same things on a regular circle, so on a regular dream catcher, this wouldn't happen. But yeah, I am learning as I go, and you are learning with me. So I will just go ahead like this and make reductions where that is absolutely a must, because we don't have space as here, we won't have more space, so I must make some reductions, and we will see what happens. Okay, so let's work. I have talked not too much, but enough. Okay, so here I cannot put my needle here, so I will put it here. I will skip just one space or one. Oh, just a second. One knot. I will skip one knot. Okay, so I have here the knot between the sections and colors of the string. So I need to get it through this very tiny space. That's okay. Okay, so can you see this reduction? There is a tiny triangle where I did it. And let's go ahead. I can see here more loosening up. And it's not my fault as the technique goes, as that wasn't loose when I was working on it. It's really, I think, just the shape of this deformed circle. But as you know, I accept imperfections. It's okay, it's a learning curve. When we make mistakes, or when we create something and we get imperfections, we gain something. We gain the possibility to not make the same mistake the next time. So it's okay. It's a reminder. It can remain there. Because that is useful. And the same is true for our life, I think. We cannot change the past, so at least we can learn from it. That that doesn't mean that don't know, I love mistakes, but at least those can be useful if we learn out of them, or thanks to them. Okay. Okay, so that is another reduction I have just made, but maybe it wasn't even necessary. That is necessary. You can see it. And I will also tell you that sometimes what happens to me is that I make some mistake, so I make something that while creating that I think that is a mistake, okay, that is an imperfection, a mistake, but usually or sometimes I just continue working and creating, okay, without correcting or worrying about it too much. And when I finish my creation, the situation is that the creation is even more special thanks to that mistake or thanks to that imperfection. Maybe a color which is not matching perfectly. But really, sometimes it's a plus. It depends. Okay, I completed this round. So, yeah, see you next time. Bye bye.